This is a Logo Archive video presentation.
Welcome to this Logo Archive special, and yes, this is my voice. Telling the story with walls of text just doesn't seem appropriate for this one, so for the first time since I ran an Animaniacs channel about a year ago, I'm putting my voice on the internet. I found out about this interesting story through Google searches, trying to find out information about another elusive sound system trailer, the original mix of the THX Cimarron trailer, which has been attempted to be reconstructed by other YouTube users. What I stumbled on wasn't about THX, however, but DTS. It is well known that DTS released two main cinema trailers in the 90s. One in 1993, dubbed The Flying Disc of Doom, and the other, much more peaceful, Sonic Landscape piano trailer in 1999. But there did exist, for a short period of time, a third trailer that was supposed to be released in 1995. However, its existence is only really known amongst film projectionist circles, and has been seen by even fewer people. Now, I haven't found the trailer today, but I will tell the wider Logo community of this third DTS trailer. This is the story of the band DTS trailer. Now, believe it or not, some people thought that DTS's flying disc trailer was a tad too noisy and bombastic. Sure, it might have had some use playing in front of Jurassic Park, for instance, but it's not really the right tone of trailer to be playing in front of a movie like Schindler's List. DTS listened to these complaints, and in late 1995 or early 1996, they released a new trailer to theatres and on their webpage. Although I doubt a lot of people had the internet speed to even watch a video in 1996. Not long after the general release of these trailers, a memo was given out to cinema managers and projectionists around America to hand back this brand new trailer. DTS effectively stopped circulation of the trailer at the same time and effectively pulled it from ever showing up again. But what was so bad about this trailer? Was it too inappropriate to be shown? Was it just a crap trailer? Well, I'm able to reconstruct the first part of this trailer for you, and it is able to be accurately reconstructed. You'll see what I mean in a minute. So now, I present to you the DTS Water Drop trailer reconstructed. Now, you're probably thinking, Logo Archive, this is just a clickbait video. You've clearly shown me the first half of the Imagine Entertainment logo. And you're correct, just not about the clickbait part. This was the exact reason the trailer was pulled. DTS's 15-second trailer was so similar to the Imagine Entertainment logo that Ron Howard's company threatened a lawsuit. DTS had no choice but to pull the trailer to avoid a costly court battle. Despite the lawsuit, DTS tried again to make a quieter, softer trailer, finally releasing Sonic Landscape around 1998-1999. As I said in the intro, the only reason we know about this trailer today is a small amount of discussion among film projectionists in projectionist forums and Laserdisc forums on the internet. Despite the ban, the trailer did get a run in two theatres in Albuquerque and St. Louis. One forum user posted about this in 2008 and again in 2013. He said that he ignored the memo by forgetting to tell the manager, conveniently, and gave a copy to a friend and kept two copies for himself, one to play in the theatre and one that to this day he claims is still sealed up in its container. The trailers ran in these cinemas for about a year before they were retired by the projectionists. The audio also showed up on DTS discs handed to projectionists to operate the DTS system for quite some time after the trailer was pulled. Although, because these were designed to play on special DTS players, it would be almost impossible to convert these discs to a common format. So, that's the story of probably one of the rarest sound system trailers around. It's highly unlikely that this trailer will ever see the light of day. Although, if you're watching this video and you remember seeing the trailer, or you might have some more information about it, drop a comment in the comment box below, or if you don't have Google+, drop me an email at the address shown.